Don't waste another minute fighting with crows, arguing with chickens, debating with turkeys. Be an eagle. Start rising above that. Several times in the scripture, it refers to the believer as an eagle. Isaiah said, "You will mount up with wings like an eagle." It's significant that God chose an eagle. An eagle can fly higher than just about any other bird. They've spotted eagles at 30,000 feet in the air, up where the big jets fly. I read where a crow is a natural pest to the eagle. Although the eagle is bigger and stronger, the crow is more agile. It can turn quicker, maneuver faster. Sometimes to annoy the eagle, the crow will follow right behind the eagle, just pestering it, trying to cause it trouble. When the eagle is tired of dealing with the crow, it doesn't try to outmaneuver it, moving left and right. It simply starts flying higher and higher. The crow can't go where the eagle can go. It can't handle that high of an altitude. Eventually, it will fall away. In life, there will always be some crows. You may work with crows. You may have neighbors that are crows. You may be sitting by a crow, just laughing. They won't know it. But there will always be people that can get on your nerves. They feel like it's their calling in life to annoy you, irritate you, push your buttons. That will continue to happen as long as you're staying down at their level. You can't control how everyone treats you, but you can control how you respond. How you handle difficult people will determine how high you will go. If you treat them the way they treat you, then you'll get stuck. The scripture says you overcome evil with good. You never overcome disrespect with more disrespect. You never get ahead doing to others what they did to you. You only have so much emotional energy each day. It's not an unlimited supply. It takes a lot of energy to get upset, to live offended, think about what they said, try to straighten them out. That's energy you need for your dreams. Don't go the next 20 years letting the same things upset you. Same grumpy relative steal your joy. They may not change, but here's the key. You can change. If they perform a certain way, it's going to sour your day. The problem is you're letting them control you. Why don't you take the controls back? If someone is disrespectful, rude, always finding fault, they have issues they haven't dealt with. Sometimes that poison will try to get off on you. You have to stay on the offensive. They may be rude, but I'm not taking the bait. I'm staying calm. I'm going to be respectful despite how they treat me. But you never go wrong by taking the high road. You never lose out when you're kind, when you overlook an offense, when you choose to stay in peace. The scripture says, when you're good to your enemies, it's like heaping coals of fire on their head. You would think if we'd treat our enemies the way they treated us, that'd be good payback. They talk bad about me, I'm going to talk bad about them. That feels good to our flesh, to let them have it. But you never come out ahead by doing to others what they did to you. The real way you see favor increase is you bless your enemies. When you're good to those that are not good to you, not only will you rise higher, but God will deal with those who are not treating you right. He knows how to heap coals of fire, how to put pressure, how to make them think differently about you. You have to realize you're an eagle. The way you get rid of crows is not engaging with them, but by going up higher. You're an eagle. You're not supposed to be fighting with crows. You're not supposed to be upset with some chickens pecking around, dealing with things that don't matter. Quit being frustrated by the turkeys, people that don't understand you, people that make a lot of noise trying to steal your peace. Those are distractions trying to get you off course, wasting time and energy that you need to pursue your goals. You can't stop the crows from crowing. You can't stop the chickens from pecking, but you can spread your wings and rise higher. You were created to soar, designed to do big things, to leave your mark, to be a history maker. Don't waste your valuable time dealing with crows. They didn't choose you before you were formed in your mother's womb. What they say cannot stop your purpose. Don't give it the time of day. Ignore it and move forward. You know what'll happen? The crows will fall away. They can't hang with you. They can't go where you're going. God put greatness in you. But there's a lot of negative chatter these days with all the social media and ways to communicate. People can express their opinions so easily and say things that are derogatory, try to discredit you. The only power that has is the power you give it. Tune out all the negative and run your race with purpose. You're an eagle. Don't come down and fight battles that don't matter. You keep soaring. Keep doing the right thing, and God will deal with the crows, the chickens, the turkeys. Psalm 45 says, God has anointed us with the oil of joy. When you walk in your anointing, there's an oil on you to where nothing can stick. You're like a Teflon pan. You have a no-stick anointing. Difficult people are all around. This is how you live happy, not by avoiding difficult people, but by not taking their garbage. If you'll do this, I believe and declare, you're not only going to enjoy your life more, but God will take care of your neighbors.